baby sleeping again. Say it no more. This is a rude awakening. Kicking the door. Back and I'm better than ever before. Don't get it mistaken. I'm ready for war. I see the ops and I'm up in the score. I catch a and jump in the Porsche. Follow the core and I'm back to the morgue.
This is the NFL on EA Sports, and we are in the Pacific Northwest at Lumen Field in Seattle, Washington. Tonight, we've got a good NFC matchup on tap between the Los Angeles Rams and the Seattle Seahawks. Here's the former Utah Ute, Matt Gay, to get this one started. And off we go from Seattle. A fairly short kick from the 14. And he tries to get as much as he can here while protecting the football as he dives to the ground. Throwing right away, here's Locke. And he's taken down. Back at his own 7. The defense rising to the challenge and setting him back on the sack.
How about the defense there trying to set the tone on the very first play of the game?
Yeah, there's a little bit of a glow here tonight because they brought the heat right out of the gate. What a good job establishing the tone for this one.
A slot man in motion right. And now Metcalf going to get a chance to run. And a productive gain out to the 14 after starting at the 7. It's a gain of 7. Now on 3rd and long, they'll look to throw. Oh, that's into a double team, and it's intercepted. That's kind of a double whammy. I mean, the interception on the opening drive, that's one thing. But to give him this field position, that's another.
Absolutely perfect start for this defense. They take the ball away on the opening possession. They know that their offense will get the ball to start the second half. They line them up in field goal position.
Touchdown, Rams! Tyler Higbee! A 15-yard touchdown grab. And the Rams use the early turnover to get on the board first here in this one. Extra point by Gay is up and good. And that makes the score 7-0. After the touchdown, it's Gay to kick this one away. And a short kick taken at about the 16. And they'll be backed up to start this drive as he's taken down right around the 15. Here's the Seattle offense ready to get this drive underway. And the interception on that opening drive winds up leading to the touchdown, so now it's kind of time to start over.
Yeah, it certainly is, and his first throw of the game. But I like the way his guys rallied around him. Oftentimes, the quarterback is the leader, right? He tells everyone what to do. In this case, I notice his linemen around him kind of patting him, saying, "Let's go, big boy. You're still our leader."
On 1st and 10, here's Locke. Dumps that off to Penny, his running back. And he takes us beyond the 35 before going out of bounds. 11 yards there and a first down for Seattle. Just the first quarter, but tackling going to be so important going forward. They've got to limit plays like that.
And that's something when you see it happen early in the game and they don't get him on the ground, you can always tell that they were concerned about it going in. Because I can just tell you, from my days, I remember being in college and worrying all offseason about our season opener opponent. And they had a receiver that could shake and bake with the best of them. I tackled him on the first pass of the game, and the relief was incredible. Ended up having a pretty decent ball game. But if I'd missed him, it would have been a
story.
Long night.
Locke's throw into the hands of Lockett. And he'll be brought down at about the 23-yard line.
And this has been a nice answer to the touchdown drive against them a few minutes ago because they've come out and reestablished the tempo. A nice throw there, and they're putting together a very strong drive as a response.
And he's going to lose yards. They take him down at the 26.
Excellent effort defensively. Tackle for loss goes to Leonard Floyd.
Plays like we just saw there. That's why they're up right now. And the defense, they're doing their job.
Yeah, it starts with the guys up front. So when you talk with GMs who are putting together a team, a lot of them say, we're going to build from the inside out, because if you control the line of scrimmage, you control the rest of the ball game. And that's what.
And he's going to have to eat this one as down he goes. A lot of ground to cover here for Locke and the Seahawks. Third and long after that sack. Back to throw. Block. That one taken in by Dwayne Eskridge. Down inside the 10. Touchdown. CD, we have seen some great runs the last few times we've been together, but I think we could at least put this one in our top five. That was a determined gallop there.
And as a former defender, I can tell you with certainty, those are the ones that have you losing sleep at night. I would not like to be in that film room on Tuesday going over that one. Just a pretty blowout from defensively, and it leads to a big blowout.
And you can see the distance traveled there after the initial contact on the next-gen stats.
So all even at seven now as they kick it away. And that one will bounce out of the back of the end zone, so we will start here at the 25. Set to begin their next drive, the Rams offense at the line.
This drive here beginning probably with a pair of motivated groups. Remember, the offense scored a touchdown on their last time out, looking to repeat that in Charles's defense. They were very frustrated after giving up six the last time on the field.
And frankly, it's just a battle of wills in a lot of ways, because you know they're both motivated, they both game plan for this drive, and they both have specific outcomes in mind. To me, it just comes down to who can execute better and which side can step up and assert its will over the other.
Here's a second and two now from the 33. Stafford gonna give this to Akers.
And brought down, but not before reaching the 45-yard line. A gain there of 12 yards and a first down LA.
We use the word relentless a lot with guys who are aggressive on the field. In this case, it really fits, doesn't it? How about his ability to break tackles and his feet never stop moving?
Meanwhile, Stafford's throw, it's complete into the hands of Higbee.
23 yards on the play.
Well, coaches always talk about finding balance on offense. I don't think you can get much more balance than this. Big time run. Big time pass.
A 1-2 combination looked pretty good.
How about that? Let's see if they can continue to take that kind of a punch, though.
Man open is Robinson. Touchdown, Rams. Allen Robinson, 31 yards.
And the Rams have taken the lead.
Extra point by Gay is up and good. And that makes the score 14-7. Following the touchdown, here's Gay to kick it away.
And this is going to be returned from middle of the end zone.
And he'll be stopped right around where he would have been had he gone down to a knee, maybe a yard shy of there at the 24. Coming to the line here to begin their next drive, the Seahawks offense.
A long drive last time out for this offense, Charles. If you remember, they started basically in the shadows of their own end zone, marched it down the field, and a lot of that was through the passing game.
And partner, as a former defensive back, I'm having almost a physical reaction watching what's happening right now. But let's give credit where it's due, because they've done an excellent job moving the ball through the air. Secondary getting picked apart pass by pass. Obviously, they need to make some adjustments there on the back end.
Yeah, because offensively, we know that they're not going to be shy about throwing that football.
No escape for Locke, and he'll go down. Dropped for a loss of seven by multiple defenders.
He continues, Charles, to be under constant pressure, and these sacks, they're starting to pile up.
And if they want to have a realistic chance in this one, they've got to change their blocking assignments. They've got to do a better job to keep him upright. If he's going to be on the deck constantly, they've got no chance to win this game.
And the slot man goes in motion left. Slot man moves right.
So they accept the penalty, of course, and push the offense backwards a bit.
After the delay, they're backed up even further for third and long. To throw it is Locke. He'll fire one downfield for Fant. He's got a man complete. It's a big play there for Seattle. 43 yards.
And that one hurts defensively. They force him into third and long, have the advantage, yet they give up the big play right there.
Yeah, their offense was already warming up on the sideline, ready to come out. So much for that three and out. Throwing on first down, but this one winds up to be incomplete.
We know it's not an easy job to go out and catch passes when people are trying to tackle you and knock the ball away, but the bottom line is that's a pass he's got to have and a pass he should have caught.
An incomplete pass on first down. That leads to a second and 10. Oh, design run for their wideout. I don't think anyone in the building fooled right there, as that one is going to blow up in their faces. Third and long, it's Locke. And that is incomplete.
How about this defense? They came up with a couple big plays in this sequence, and none better than the one right there, forcing the incompletion and bringing up fourth down.
Locke gonna go on fourth down. He hits his target, Lockett. And he is gonna have
quit,
the Seahawks first down.
Quit, nigga. Quit, nigga. Quit, nigga.
So not only do quit, they come on fourth, but they pick up 22 yards in the process. On first down, Locke. The loop, and he can't find anywhere to go with it, and he goes down. Now the Seahawks going to use the first of their timeouts as they'll talk things over prior to this upcoming second down play. Another try after the first down sack. Lock. Out to the right, he gets it to Lockett. And he's out of bounds, almost gets to the 10. That'll wind up a gain of 27 on the catch and run.
Quarterbacks love slant routes because the receivers are breaking right into their line of vision. And receivers love them as well because they're getting the ball on the move and able to catch it and try and get upfield and gain additional yardage.
Flush to his right. Leaves it for Penny. Touchdown, Seahawks! Rashad Penny, a 12-yard touchdown grab. And the Seahawks are an extra point away from tying the ball game here in the final minute of the first half.
It don't matter, boy. As long as I get in that end zone, it don't matter. Hey, it don't matter, boy. Boy, you a scrub, boy. You a scrub, boy. scrub.
Set to begin their
two times, boy.
Rams offense at the line. And with a little under a minute to play, they may be looking to pick up some yardage here. Maybe try
three times, boy. Three times, boy. Three times, boy.